What we're going to look at right now is a feature called the concordancer. So basically what that does is it looks at these words, these terms in context. So it looks at what comes before them and what comes after them so we can see how they're actually used in real life. Next to any term, there's this thing that looks like two boxes. And if we click on one we're not sure about, let's say IPBES, you can see that it pulls up some examples from the text itself, from our corpus that it's created on the fly. And it's found, here it is, the first time IPBES showed up, we can actually see that it was the Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform for Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services. What about biodiversity friendly? Let's see how that tends to be used. All right, so biodiversity friendly practices, biodiversity friendly afforestation and reforestation, biodiversity friendly soil cover, biodiversity friendly investments, biodiversity friendly trade. Let's look at one that is a multi-word term. All right, so biodiversity loss. What verb would go with it? Well, it threatens food systems, or it is a threat. Biodiversity loss can result in various things like reduced crop yields and fish caches. And one of the things we might try to do to address biodiversity loss is reverse biodiversity loss. Let's look at organic farming. You can see where it's coming up in our document, but we can also, at the bottom here, where it says, do you want to see more examples in the reference corpus? See them in Sketch Engine. We can click right there. And we can see that this is actually a much larger reference corpus that it's drawing on. This part doesn't actually matter where it's taking it from. It's basically just normal use. And we can see, right, funding for organic farming practices, et cetera. And we can even see where this is coming from. EDU sources, various experts, non-experts, et cetera. So this is the broader concordancer that it is, that is pulling this information from the reference corpus.